Hello, my friends. So as I introduce Quantum Body to the world, my new book, The New Science of Living a Longer, Healthier, More Vital Life, with my two colleagues, Jack Tuzinski and Brian Fertig. Jack is a quantum physicist and Brian is a neuroendocrinologist and metabolic expert like me. As I introduce the ideas in this next few talks of mine or videos or whatever we call them, let me share with you what I think are the major revolutions that are happening right now in the world of healthcare, medicine, and the future of well-being, the major revolutions that will completely change the way we look at longevity, health span, and the future of well-being, and the evolution of our consciousness all together. Is there anything that we are missing? And if we are, I'd love to hear from you, because this is very important. We need to overthrow the old reductionist model, other than when it works for acute illness. But we need to really, together as a world movement, ensure the future of well-being, which is more holistic, and if it followed all the way, could lead to a more peaceful, just, sustainable, healthier, and joyful world. That's the future of well-being, a more peaceful, just, sustainable, healthier, and joyful world. So first of all, what are the major revolutions or developments that have taken place in the last, let's say, two decades? I'll start with the one that's most recent, and that is artificial intelligence, which will help us put everything that I'm saying, help us put it all together. Okay, so that's the latest. AI is the latest. Now I'm going to mention the others. So the second major revolution is the microbiome. 99% or so of our genetic information is in the microbiome, and we can replace our microbiomes. In other words, most of the genetic information in your body is replaceable, and the human genes that are there can be upgraded. So let's call the second revolution microbiome. The third, which is also technical, is CRISPR and gene editing. You should be able to cut and paste genes the same way as you cut and paste emails. And that's going to actually get rid of diseases that are due to fully penetrant genes. So let's call that the third revolution. The fourth revolution is understanding the way mRNA, which is messenger RNA, translates transcription into the body's proteins. So, you know, transcription is DNA replicating itself. Translation is when mRNA, messenger RNA, takes over. And with this technology, we have the means to literally create trillions of proteins and also develop trillions of new pharmaceuticals, which will be much more intelligent than the current pharmaceuticals, which are mostly synthetic. But with messenger RNA, we'll be able to replicate the body's own healing capacities. So let's call that the fourth major revolution in the future of well-being. The fifth is what we're learning from epigenetics and the role of epigenetics, meaning how do we basically optimize both gene activity and epigenetic modulation of that gene activity. And that, of course, leads to the sixth revolution, which is neuroplasticity. How can we change the landscape of the brain for a more joyful, energetic body, loving, compassionate heart, clear mind, and lightness of being? So I would say let's call the fifth epigenetics, the sixth neuroplasticity. And that, of course, leads to the seventh, which is the role of holistic practices, including all the eight limbs of yoga: yama, niyama, yogasana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyan, samadhi, because I think that's the complete prescription for total revision of our neural networks and the synaptic connections for a joyful, energetic body, loving, compassionate heart, clear mind, and lightness of being, which are the prerequisite for a more peaceful, just, sustainable, healthier world, and also health span and longevity. So let's call that the meditation and yoga revolution. Okay, let's call it the seventh major pillar. They're not in importance, in order of importance. So the seventh is the meditation and yoga practices for total well-being. And finally, the eighth, I would say, is longevity, which is the final consequence of everything I've said: health span and longevity. Notice I haven't talked about self-realization, which is ultimate healing, and we'll go there. So let's make that the eighth aspect, the eighth revolution. Okay, meditation and yoga practices for total well-being. Okay, so why do I still think that AI is part of this revolution? Because AI just happened to come along in the last few years, and especially after the COVID pandemic. I think AI is going to be the most important aspect of everything I've said, because it is through AI that we can create a technology that will show the instant correlations between mental processes and gene activity, neuroplasticity, and metabolism. Artificial intelligence is rapidly advancing and is already being used in a variety of healthcare applications, including the diagnosis of diseases, the development of new treatments, and the improvement of patient care. One of the strengths of this AI is the ability to process large amounts of data quickly and efficiently. This data makes it well suited for analyzing the complex relationships between mental processes, gene activity, neuroplasticity, and metabolism. AI can also be used to develop algorithms that identify patterns in the data that would be otherwise very difficult or impossible to detect by human experts. For example, AI could be used to analyze brain imaging data to identify changes in gene activity that are associated with specific mental disorders. While I'm saying this, I also caution that brain imaging is overused right now, but when used selectively, it's very useful. In any case, all these developments could lead to new diagnostic tests and treatments for both physical disorders and mental disorders. AI could also be used to track the effects of different interventions on gene activity. This could help researchers to understand how these factors contribute to health and disease. Of course, we still have many challenges to address before AI can be used to create a technology that shows instant correlations between mental processes and gene activity, neuroplasticity, and metabolism. One challenge, in fact, is the sheer amount of data that needs to be collected and analyzed. Another challenge is the complexity of the relationships between those factors. However, I'm certain that these challenges will be overcome, and that AI has the potential to revolutionize our understanding of mind body as inseparably entangled in the field of all possibilities, which is pure consciousness. So, right now, there are some people who are already using AI in healthcare to study the relationship between mental processes and gene activity, neuroplasticity, and metabolism. For example, a team of researchers at the University of California, San Francisco, are using AI to analyze brain imaging data to identify changes in gene activity that are associated with depression. They believe that this could lead to the development of new diagnostic tests and also multiple ways of tackling depression. A team of researchers at the University of Cambridge are using AI to track the effects of different interventions on gene activity, neuroplasticity, and metabolism in people with Alzheimer's disease. They believe that this could help them to develop new therapies, both, ultimately sound therapies, ultrasound, AI-delivered electroceuticals, and newer mRNA kind of developments that will lead to intelligent pharmaceuticals that replicate human intelligence or the biological intelligence that we have. In this context, there's also a team of researchers at the University of Texas Southwestern Medical Center who are using AI to develop a personalized medicine approach to treating cancer. We at the Chopra organization are creating our own AI assisted telemedicine platform. In any case, this kind of information could then be used to select the most effective treatments and personalize them for patients with cancer, but with also other chronic illnesses. So this is the future of well-being. I believe that the future is full of innovation, promising innovations and technology. In summary, AI, microbiome, CRISPR and gene editing, messenger RNA, epigenetics, neuroplasticity, and one thing I forgot to mention. Let's make it number nine. I don't know how many points I mentioned, but that would be the psychedelic revolution if I didn't mention it as part of the whole process of getting insight into the non-local awareness, which we access through meditation as well. So the psychedelic revolution, the epigenetic revolution, the neuroplasticity revolution, the meditation and yoga movement, and everything that I've said. And this is just the beginning. Quantum body, quantum mind, quantum universe. I need your feedback.